diferente. Como luz amaneces primero. Todo es diferente. Y mi viaje contigo es ligero.
Yo por ti sé que vi un mundo en primavera. Y te vi para mí. ¿Quién más si no eras solo tú? Se ve, es que pronto va a amanecer. En el alma yo te encontré. Hey, yeah.
Get on, get on, and take off your shoes, partner. There you go.
Hey, come on, partner with us.
Yes.
Oh, baby, there you are. Mm.
Oh, baby. Okay, listen, listen. Who ordered pizza when what we have is sushi? Huh? Well, pay for it because I don't have any money. Come here, partner. You sit down. Have a drink.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, sir. I'm working.
Ah, did you just get here?
No, no, I've been here for 7 years.
So now it's already been 7 years since you've seen your family.
7 years, yes.
So what's your name?
Emilio Romero.
Omar. Are you legal?
Of course, yes. Now, if you'll excuse me, I really have to go deliver some pizzas. It's going to be $70. It's just $70.
It's your tip, boy.
Thank you very much. Leo, what do you want?
Listen, brother, there's something online that you might want to check.
Listen, buddy, get serious. What do you want? I'm really behind schedule today.
What's her name, that girlfriend you had in Bogota?
Lorena Redin. Why?
Brother, I'm at the airport. But let's meet at the terrace right now, and I'll tell you.
Emilio, Lorena Redin, right?
I don't want anything to do with her. You know she made me suffer, man.
I know, but you have to see this.
What is this?
A social network page.
And?
Okay, let me explain. It turns out that a friend of a friend of mine turned out to be friends with her ex, Lorena. And she posted these pictures online.
What are they?
Look.
Lorena has a daughter?
Yes. But check this out.
Oh, look, she's got a daughter. Look, man, she's got a daughter.
This picture, who do you think she looks like?
Mrs. Lorena, you have a phone
call. Thank you. Hello?
Hello, Lorena?
Who is this?
Emilio.
Ooh. Emilio?
Romero, don't you remember my voice?
Oh, I'm sorry, but I am... why are you calling me?
Listen, I just saw some pictures of you online, and you're there with a little girl. Tell me, is that your daughter?
I'm really busy right now. I'm sorry.
You know what? There's really no easy way to do this, so I'm just going to go ahead and ask you. Is that little girl my daughter?
Are you crazy? How dare you call me after such a long time to ask me such a question?
Look, the girl doesn't look like me, but she looks just like my mother. Look, Lorena, if you ever loved me the same way that I loved you, and if you respected me, Lorena, don't hang up on me, okay? What's the girl's name?
Her name's Valentina.
Is Valentina my daughter?
Emilio, please. Yes, she's yours.
How could you not tell me this? My God, Lorena!
What for? When I realized that I was pregnant, you already left.
But that's what the mail is for. The letters and the emails.
Yes, but you disappeared from my life.
But that was because you left me and you told me to never contact you again, Lorena!
Emilio, it's the same. Why would I bother you with a last-minute unexpected event?
Unexpected? Oh, no, not unexpected. This unexpected event is 6 years old. My God, she has my smile! Lorena, if I had known that you were pregnant, I would have stayed in Colombia and I would have supported you. I would have taken care of you.
Calm down. We already found a wonderful man. He's taking good care of us.
Does Valentina know I exist?
No. I mean, yes. Yes, she knows that she has a father somewhere around the world, but that's all our daughter knows.
I want that to change.
Hey, who are you talking to? Lorena! Bum, 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 bum. I'm a dad, Leo! I have a daughter, and she's spectacular!
Yes, brother, she's beautiful.
I have to go to Colombia. I don't know how, but I have to go back to Colombia.
But you would lose your status.
Oh, I don't care about my status. I'm a dad! I really want to meet her!
Yes.
I have to go get a ticket.
Omar.
Who's Omar?
Don Omar from the yacht, remember?
I was there today.
He owns a travel agency.
Oh, no
yes,
way,
it
brother!
Get any easier
this is so
than
cool.
That.
Valentina's
of course.
So beautiful. I'm looking for Omar.
Mr. Omar?
Yes.
Why are you looking for him?
Business?
Business, what kind of business?
Personal.
Personal, just wait, okay?
Yes? And who are you?
Don Omar. I'm Emilio Romero. I delivered pizzas to you. Do you remember me?
No, I don't remember.
Well, I'm here because I heard that you owned a travel agency and I need to travel urgently. Look, I can't pay for the whole ticket right now, but if we can find some kind of arrangement, I need to travel to Bogota.
Bogota? So do you think you could do me a favor? I usually travel every month to take some clothes to a shelter home that I have there, but I can't make it this month. If you take it from me, I'll give you a ticket.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Yes, of course.
Come in,
yes, sir.
Then.
All right.
Okay.
I told you, ladies, that you can't bring your lunch from home.
No,
the
sir,
workplace
no,
regulation
no,
in this company is very strict.
Girls, whatever the doctor says, it's the law. Go back
please,
to your places.
Move that.
Please.
Come on,
yes,
excuse me. Hurry
really
up there, will
this.
You?
Oh, my God.
Oh, and you. This is not a story, young lady. Please put away all these stuffed
no,
toys.
No,
you're too
no,
old for
my
them anyway.
Animals, no.
This is not the image we want to project in this company. Who's eating eggs? Huh? Olga, do me a favor and put those eggs away. The doctor is going to come out of the office.
Hello,
and this
Copito Industries President's Office. Yes, just a minute. I'll put you through.
We want people to think of us as a very professional
Helen,
company.
You have a phone call from New York.
Hello?
Hey, how are you doing, Mr. Segura?
Bad, but I'm getting used to it. When are you sending me the money?
Hey, that is the reason why I called, because you don't have to worry now that I found the guy who will bring you the money.
And the pig? The little pork? Are you sure it's safe to send the money through that guy?
Of course it's safe, because you know very well, sir, that the most needy and trusting are the safest of them all.
This guy has all the qualifications, so the day after
tomorrow, you'll have your money over there in Bogota. But I'm sure you're not needing it so bad, right, Mr. Segura?
Do you know what it's like to support two beautiful women in the 21st century? My girlfriend loves expensive shoes, and the other likes them too. We'll talk later, Leathery. That's your nickname. Oh, you're so beautiful that I see you in slow motion.
Mm. Oh. Mm,
I was meaning to talk to you.
Yeah, me?
Oh. Yes, yes, girls.
Move that. Come on, excuse me. Hurry up.
It's just that I really need you to sign some papers for me.
Oh, I thought that you wanted me to kiss you, pamper you,
no.
Touch you.
No, baby, I really have to send this fax.
Well, we can do it together, baby.
Felix, stop.
You're going to have to hire a commercial manager who has time for me. You're fired.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, first of all, I don't think you're really capable of that.
I'm not?
No, and second, I always have some time for you.
I understand.
Yes, the thing is...
We have a meeting.
Yes, I'll stop at your office later and take you the papers.
Carry on.
Lorena, this is Emilio. I left you 1,000 messages. Please pick up. I want to see Valentina today. I want to see my daughter. I'm on my way to the airport. I'll call you as soon as I get there. Bye. Don Omar, I'm so sorry. I was running late.
That's not good, brother. I'm in a hurry. Get the suitcase.
This one?
Yes. Put it over there.
Yeah. You know, thanks for waiting for me.
Yes.
I've been running all day.
Now check it.
Well, there's no need, but I mean, who knows?
Better if you do. So everything okay?
Okay.
Well, somebody will be waiting for you at the airport. He'll know who you are.
Thank you very much, really. I'll be eternally grateful to you. Thank you.
Okay.
See ya. Tell me, what is going on? I don't understand anything. Look, I swear I just got back from New York and that's all I know. It's part of the deal I made. It's part of the deal.
Just come this way.
They told me that if I brought back this suitcase, they would pay for my ticket. But I checked the suitcase and I saw that it only had clothes, okay? I swear, it only had clothes. I don't know what else
is
in there.
Let us do our job, please, and,
Yes, but try to understand. I just don't know why you brought me here, okay? You see, it's just clothes. Take a look. It's clothes. Just clothes, okay?
This, sir?
No. That's not mine. Look, I swear it was full of clothes, okay? When I checked the suitcase, I had no idea.
Let's detain him.
I had no idea what was in there. I didn't even know that there was money. Please, come on, let me go, man. It's not my fault. I didn't know. Let me go. I didn't know. I swear, I didn't know. Oh, come on, let me go. Oh, I didn't know it had a double layer, okay? I had no idea that that was there. Please, you have to believe me.
Thank you.
Good morning. Please sit down. Let's begin this session. Mr. Emilio Romero, do you know that it's a felony to bring more than $10,000 in cash to the country? You had $1 million hidden in your suitcase.
Look, Your Honor, I swear to God, I had no idea that money was in there. Otherwise, I would never have agreed to the deal.
What deal are you talking about?
I offered myself to bring some clothes in that suitcase. You saw them. Those clothes belonged to some guy, and I brought them in exchange for the plane ticket.
Do you know the name of that person?
Yes, I do, ma'am. It's Don Omar. Which is probably not even his real name, probably. Look, Your Honor, I swear, I had no idea. This happened to me because I trusted him. For no other reason than I'm an idiot, but I'm not a criminal, okay? I'm not a delinquent. I'm an honest man, okay? I'm a hard-working man. I used to work in a pizza place in New York. Its name is Rudy's. The owner is Colombian. If you want, you can call and confirm everything that I'm saying. I was in a real rush to come here because, well, I just found out that I have a 6-year-old daughter, and the only thing I wanted was to come here, and that's why I looked for Don Omar, because he owns a travel agency, and it was because I wanted to meet her. That's why I ended up here.
When he gave you the suitcase, is it packed already?
Yes, ma'am. It was already packed.
Would you be willing to collaborate with the justice authorities?
Yes, of course, Your Honor. The only thing I wanted to do was to meet my daughter.
Mr. Emilio Romero, due to the conditions of your capture, I can't exonerate you from the charges that are made against you. The fact is that we found you with these dollars in your suitcase. But if you collaborate with us, we can come up with an arrangement.
Documents down to the warehouse to confirm the delivery of this morning's offer. Jency, are you writing this down?
Well, in my mind, ma'am.
Why don't you write this down, okay? I don't want you to forget anything.
No, don't worry, ma'am. I don't forget anything.
Okay, then run, woman. Hurry up, please.
Hey, Antonia. What's up, still working?
Jency, why are you not doing what I ask you to do?
Oh, you meant today?
No.
Excuse me, ma'am.
The secretary is going to drive me insane, I swear.
She's slow, huh?
And you know what's worse? I think Mario is hitting on her.
No, that sounds just like your brother-in-law and his bad taste. Nothing like his brother, who has excellent taste.
Felix is so serious and responsible, huh?
Responsible? I mean, Mario is something. And his story is just impossible. But you know what? I'm going to leave because I see that you're busy and I guess you're going to be here all day?
Well, yeah.
Oh, well, okay. I'm going because I have to say hello to an aunt who is really sick.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'll tell you about it later. Take care.
Mwah. Listen, you can come visit me whenever you want.
All right. Bye, my friend.
Bye.
Was made in New York City against a gang of Colombian men who used mules so they can send illegal money to Colombia. It leaves a balance of 10 captured people and millions of dollars seized. The authorities are chasing after the trace of the gang leaders who are assumed
what
to be in the country
this
at
time?
The moment.
Oh no, why?
Felix, I forgot to tell you that my friend Antonia said hello.
No. Not now, please. Not right now. I don't want to. Stop. Come on, stop. Please, stop. No. Oh, no, I said...
Why are you going to act indifferent, huh? I know you want me to beg you, right? Oh, come on. Why are you such a...
No, what I mean is that... Stop that. I'm really not in the mood right now. I lost so much money. This doesn't work, okay?
Don't be like that. I'll help you find what you want.
You'll help me? Really?
Yes.
So shut up, get dressed, and leave.
Felix, this is my house.
Okay, so shut up and I'll get dressed.
Oh, you're so boring. Why are you leaving? I'll help you find anything.
What?
Oh.
What?
It's Antonia. Oh, I really want to gossip with my...
No, I swear.
Oh.
I'm not in the mood. Hello, my darling.
Hello, baby. How was your day?
Well, it's been a...
Come and get it.
A long day, but it was good. I brought some work home, and I think it was a mistake.
Oh, were you able to go to your meetings?
Well, yes, I'm almost done with one, and then I'm heading to another one, you know, the milk suppliers.
I see. I'm working as well. Listen, how about I go to your house for a while and we can have a drink? I would love some wine right now.
Yes, baby. I would love to have some wine with you, but I think this meeting is going to be long, you know? Well, why don't we talk and we'll see. Let's see each other in the office. Don't you think so? That's a good idea.
Oh, okay. No, I understand. Okay, so get me some rest, and we'll talk tomorrow.
Okay, baby. Thank you.
Hello, my dear Antonia.
Mario.
So, you're working late again? That's not life, Antonia. You shouldn't be leaving my brother alone because somebody might come and... steal him away.
Oh, thank you for your advice, but I have to finish this and, like you say, get a life.
Speaking of getting a life and the fact that you can't have one or want one, doesn't mean that you have to force our employees not to have one either, right?
Uh-huh. Can you explain to me what you're talking about, huh?
I'm talking about our excellent and charismatic secretary, Jensi. She has worked all day long. You're turning her into a slave, making her work so late. She leaves and she can't find a ride home.
Oh, and you're so considerate that you're dying to take her home, right? Or perhaps to your home?
Be very careful, Antonia. I don't like the sarcasm. You know that I worry about the well-being of our employees. I have a socialist heart.
Oh, okay, so don't worry, because Jensi gets paid overtime. She even told me that this month was going to be really good for her, and that a company's car will take her home.
Oh, really? Too bad. How much does that cost the company?
Mario, don't insist. Jensi is going to stay working with me today, better yet, finishing what she didn't do during the day, and only God knows why she didn't do it. And you know what? I'm not going to waste your time because I can see that you're in a rush.
You know what? I'm in no rush
you
at all.
You are too.
I am in a rush.
Mr. Emilio Romero. We consider that you were the source that helped us to capture Don Omar. That's why we've decided to give you conditional freedom. However, it's important for you to know that conditional freedom forces you to comply with several rules. If you don't, you could go to jail. The first rule, you cannot commit any other fault, not to mention a crime. Second, you can't leave the city. And the third one, and the most important one, you have to stay in contact with me every other week.
Thank you.
Lorena, did you get the messages where I told you I was coming?
Yes, but I didn't think that you were going to do it.
Well, now I'm here.
I see that.
It wasn't my intention to bother you. I just want to meet my daughter. And you have no idea the kind of trouble I'd had to go through to travel from the United States. I'm not leaving without meeting my daughter.
You have 5 minutes. The girl is upstairs in her bedroom, and she's about to fall asleep, and she has to sleep 10 hours. You have 4 minutes.
Okay, got it.
Emilio! Emilio! Emilio, one moment! Emilio!
Emilio. Can you tell me your name?
Valentina Sotomayor Redin.
Wow. What a beautiful name.
Are you a friend of my mommy?
Yes. Yes. You see, we met a long time ago.
You met in school?
No, a little bit after that. Actually, a few years.
The thing is that Emilio and I met a long time ago. We met during...
Remember that I told you that I'm not your biological father? But I'm actually your heartological father.
Then are you my real dad?
Yes.
Jency?
Mom? Oh.
Nice to meet
you. Oh, yes, ma'am.
Jency!
Oh.
Ow!
I found the pencil I was looking for.
Oh my, and you lost your shoe as well?
Oh, thank you very much for helping me find it, sir.
Come on, Jency, we don't have to give anybody any explanation, as if.
Oh, you don't?
It's not what you're thinking, ma'am. Excuse me.
Antonia, let me tell you something, okay? When you come into my office, do me a favor and knock. Give me some respect. You're not going to bother me or my rubber ducky. What? Are you going to call the police or the convent? My brother.
Yes, your brother. Perhaps we can finally end this repetitive and absurd situation.
Absurd situation.
I want more.
More? What's wrong with you? If I was strong enough to get up, I would have left an hour ago. No, no, stop it. Enough. Antonia might stop by my house. Come on. Enough. Please.
Antonia lives in the office.
Stop. Come on. Not again. Come on. Stop. Please. Oh, no. I said stop. No. Stop it. Stop it. Come on. I said, give me my phone. Hello, baby. Good. Good. You know, I'm just about to leave for the meeting I told you about, the meeting with the supplier. He's very demanding. Is everything okay, huh?
Well, Felix, I have a problem here with your brother. Can you believe I found him under his desk getting busy with my secretary?
With our secretary?
I can't believe this. How disgusting. Let me speak with him.
Oh, he wants to talk to you.
No.
Well, talk.
Hello?
Felix, it's not what you're thinking.
I really don't care how things are. Just make sure you look like an idiot and do what she says, okay?
Yes, sir.
Put me on speaker.
Just like Antonia said, Mario.
This is such a lack of respect, and you really are at fault here.
This is absurd. Now, baby, what is your plan?
Well, I think the best thing to do is for Jency to go down to the garage and for us to hire a new secretary for the commercial area.
Somebody new. I have no problem with that.
What's wrong? Are you okay?
Yes. You see, I'm just driving by a junction, and a truck almost hit me, but everything is just fine. So Gen Z goes to the garage, and we find a new secretary, huh? Now, let Tony choose her, okay?
If you say so.
If you say so.
Are we all happy, huh? I have to go
because my hands-free cable got tangled. This is a little bit complicated, okay? Goodbye.
Listen, I am going to hire a secretary that doesn't interest you at all.
I hope she's very ugly. They tend to be very great.
Oh, you're disgusting.
I hope you're very lucky in this new mission.
Oh, my dear Mario, I'm sure there's somebody out there who won't let you put a finger on them.
Why haven't you come to see me before?
My love, do you remember when I told you that... that your dad lived in another country? Do you remember?
I used to live in the United States, but I came to see you. Valentina, you're so pretty. See you tomorrow. Bye. I guess I have to give Valentina enough time to assimilate all this.
So you are the famous Emilio.
You've heard about me?
No, the truth is that Lorena never mentions you. I'm just saying. Nice to meet you, Franco Sotomayor.
So you're the last name.
Well, the important thing here is that you met the girl and the girl met you, and... And...
So how is this going to work from now on?
What's going to work?
My visits. When am I going to see Valentina? How will this be organized?
No, Emilio, just a moment. We're okay as it is.
What did you expect, Lorena? For me to disappear just like that?
Well, yes, that's what I hoped for, yes.
No, listen. I'm not here to displace anybody or take anybody's place. No. I'm her father, and I have certain rights and obligations.
I think it's okay for him to see her.
What is your current situation?
I don't have a house and I don't have a job.
I guess you can see the girl. But for now, she can't leave this house.
What a coincidence!
Hello, my love. How are
Hello.
You? Did you get some rest?
A little bit tired. It was a long meeting. A tough one. Tiring, but...
Oh, I'm sorry, really. I didn't mean to bother you about Mario when you're in a meeting.
It's okay. I know my brother is a jerk ever since he was born.
No, I think the problem with him is something hormonal.
No, he's just spoiled. He's really spoiled. Okay. Well, as soon as I get back from Cartagena, I'm going to talk to him and I'm going to set him straight, okay? Even if it's the last thing I have to do. This company is not a cabaret. And him fooling around with a secretary, my goodness, it's absurd.
Okay, look, on my part, I'm going to start looking for a secretary starting today. One that Mario can put a finger on, ever.
I support you, as always.
Oh, hey, at what time are you leaving for Cartagena? Are we going to have lunch together?
No, I have to go at noon.
Oh, what a shame.
Slut calling.
Ah,
okay,
hey.
Leave me alone.
What's wrong?
This provider, he's driving me nuts.
Hello, how are you?
Hello?
What kind of job are you looking for?
Something in accounting where I can move up.
With that judicial pass, that's going to be impossible, young man.
Nice.
Well, can't you see you have a criminal record? So please get out of my business. Please go out. Hurry up, young man. I don't want to see you around here. Come on, get out.
Can you give me an appointment for today? For a job, yes. Look, I'm perfect for it. I'm the perfect candidate.
It says here that you worked in New York.
Well, I used to work in the area of culinary arts, customer service, and public relations, but accounting is my thing.
Really? But do you have a criminal record?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry for you, man.
I've been looking for a job all over town, and you have no idea. All the doors have been closed in my face because of my judicial certificate. It's a misunderstanding. I brought a suitcase full of clothes, and it turned out to be full of dollars. And of course, I'm the one who looks like a criminal here. So now I'm looking for a job up and down, up and down, up and... Oh, ma'am, can I get a little bit of butter? Thank you very much, ma'am. Oh, your food was really delicious. Do you happen to know if they need an accountant around here?
Oh, no, sir. This is too small to have an accountant. But you know what? You can ask next door, which seems like a little good company.
Thank you very much. This is a paper, okay? That's it, ma'am. You're full of prejudice. Have you ever made a mistake in your life? Well, I have. I have. And you know what? It's very easy for you to judge everybody else. Keep judging. Keep judging them, of course. Oh, I'm the one who's like a criminal here. Yes, I'm always the criminal here.
Everything has a beginning and an end, a start and a finish, from A to Z, yin and yang, A-E-I-O-U, Genesis and Apocalypse. In the Bible, Jesus gives us a very beautiful verse in St. John's chapter 11, verse 35, which says, Jesus cried. And if he cried, then why wouldn't you cry, Jensen?
Of course, of course.
In the name of the administration department.
On three.
Uh-huh. One, two.
Three. We want to give you this and tell you that we don't want to see you like that, okay? You know, for the Greeks, when a woman cries, it means that, well...
Hey, don't be like that.
Hey, you owe me one like this. Are you going to pay or are you going to steal it?
Call your grandma a thief.
I just bought it to help
you
out.
No, calm down.
It's all right.
Jensy, calm down, okay? Why don't you tell us what happened, huh? I don't understand because the bosses were just pleased with your work.
You mean displeased? Shh! Everybody's just jealous of me, starting with Dr. Antonia. That's why they took it out on me.
Oh, that's just your excuse.
Oh, ladies, no, ladies, ladies.
Oh,
ladies,
really
ladies,
now?
Ladies,
no,
that's enough. Gently, Catalina.
Stop it,
enough. A little respect.
Oh, shut up, you.
Come on, please think about it. Why would Dr. Antonia be jealous of you? My God. Do me a favor and go get to your new workplace. Don't say anything else. Be grateful they didn't fire you. Be thankful for
really?
That.
That's right. You know what? You're right. I'm going downstairs where there aren't any jealous women.
In the name of the administration department.
On three.
One, two.
Three. We want to take your box to a much better place.
Go ahead.
Excuse me.
Hey, flatterer.
Oh, just a little.
I'm coming back, or my name isn't Jensi Catalina.
Whatever.
Oh,
come on.
Girls, do you know what's really bothering me? What really worries me? With this new vacancy, they're going to look for a replacement among us three.
Oh, no.
No, that's true. Because Mr. Felix won't allow that, but among us two, they will, and we have to put up with Dr. Mario, who is crazy and demented.
Oh, yes, you're right.
Back to work! Collect your tape.
Go! I'm sorry, I can't help you. The hotel is completely full and we don't have any vacant rooms. It's going to be really hard around here because everything's full.
That's okay, thank you.
Oh, I'm really sorry.
It's okay.
Al despertar, cada vez que un día empieza, voy por la calle con ligereza y andar así.
Believe me, mister, we don't have any vacant rooms.
Look, brother, can I stay on that couch that you have over there?
No, you have to leave, please.
Que no quieres ser, debes permanecer real y libre, libre.
Me absorbe el tiempo lento, de adentro hacia afuera es distinto. Ciudades como laberinto, solo en el olvido, por decirlo así. Por allí se comenta alerta, difícil vivir. Este no es tu tiempo, no es tu cita. Búsqueda en inversa de lo que no se necesita. De nada vale amanecer si no te quita esa máscara de tristeza que te mortifica.
What?
What? Oh, what?
Why are you staring at me?
No, it's nothing, Miss Antonia.
I wanted to ask you if you already found that person, that secretary, for the vacant position in the company.
No, Castillo. I haven't. The thing is...
Yes, ma'am?
No, Castillo. Do you happen to know somebody with a mustache or a hairy mole or something like that? Do you know?
No, no. The only person I know who fits that description is my Aunt Luz, but she's retired. Mm. Nowadays, all the ladies take really good care of their facial hair. Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. What I mean is that they take really good care of themselves.
Yes, I know, but...
But if you don't mind my asking, madam, tell me, why do you want to find a secretary who fits that description?
Let's see. Well, because it's a personal reason. But thanks. I'm going to have to keep looking for her.
Don't worry about it. I'll start looking as well, madam. Excuse me.
Okay, bye.
Hey, Antonia. How's the mission? I need to find that secretary as soon as possible because I'm really tired. I'm going crazy.
Really?
Listen, the most important thing is to find somebody who's really efficient. Somebody who can do it all.
Good morning, miss. Copito Industries? Yes, if you would be so kind. The thing is that I'm calling about the ad in the paper where you guys were looking for an accounting assistant, yes? Yes, it's just that I'm really interested in the job and I wanted to know if you can give me an appointment.
Okay, who wants to go next?
Yes? Of course, yeah. Emilio Romero. Yes, I have the address. Thank you very much. I'm on my way. Oh, brother, how much do I owe you?
For 2 minutes, it's 400, sir.
Here, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
When you get to that corner, take a right.
Thank you very much.
Good luck.
Thanks again.
How can I help you, sir?
I'm here for the job interview, please.
Oh, you're here for the interview.
Yes.
May I see some ID, please?
Of course.
All right, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good afternoon.
I'm sorry, I didn't say hello a while ago. The thing is that I'm a little bit nervous because I'm here for a job interview. Yeah, this company's a little big, huh? Who would have thought that selling toilet paper was such a good business? Of course it's a great business because everybody has to use it, sometimes even twice a day. Oh, no, okay. No, not just for that, no. Well, it's just that sometimes you have to clean your nose or clean something. You know what? I'm going to shut up now. I'm just nervous, and I talk really fast, and I'm sweating through my suit and everything. If you'll excuse me. Do you know where the door to the interview is?
Yes. The third floor.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, I got it. You here for the interview as well?
No.
Oh, but let me warn you about something. That job is mine. Don't get your hopes up. In fact, if you want to, when I get the job and I look really elegant, I'm going to buy you some dinner.
Oh, yeah? Okay,
yeah.
Deal. Yes,
sure,
of course.
Yeah.
But you know what? It's going to have to be after the interview.
Well, why is that?
Because I'm the one who's interviewing you. Antonia Fontalvo, are you going to leave me like this?
No, I'm sorry. Emilio Romero.
Emilio Romero.
Yes,
very
please
nice
forgive
to
me.
Meet you.
I'm sorry for hitting on you.
No, it's okay. Well...
Yes, of course.
I'll see you in a bit.
Sure, I'll see you in a bit. What have I done?
diferente. Como luz amaneces primero. Todo es diferente. Y mi viaje contigo es ligero.
Yo por ti sé que vi un mundo en primavera. Y te vi para mí. ¿Quién más si no eras solo tú? Pronto va a amanecer, en el alma yo te encontré. Hey, yeah.